Hi, I'm Javier Bailo and I'm 21 years old. Many people call me Javi. I live in Luján, Buenos Aires province, in Argentina. I think that what influenced me the most to be who I am at the moment was music. I took my first steps in music at school when I was 12 years old. The teacher taught us to play a melodic flute and I was very excited about learning songs. I became very curious and wanted to learn more and more. My grandparents saw my enthusiasm and let me go to play the piano at their house from time to time. When my grandparents died, my parents helped me bring the piano to my house and I started going to private lessons. Without the help of my parents and grandparents, I don't know if I would have continued with music. After taking private lessons, I went to a popular music school and learned a little jazz, tango, folklore and rock. Although I liked it, I was very dependent of the people and I couldn't really enjoy the music, so I moved to a conservatory of classical music. There, I felt more comfortable and was able to fully exploit my reading ability. I was there for a couple of years and I realized that perfecting the technique and playing in such a structured way made me want to quit music. At that moment, I decided to change my career and study psychology. It was a difficult decision, but I realized that in my particular case, so that I could live from music, I was going to stop loving it progressively. The problem was not with music, but with me. I do believe that life without music would be meaningless, and that's why I know that I will never completely separate myself from music. Now, I enjoy it from another side. I teach people who are just beginning to play and are in the curious stage, as I was at 12. And also, I play songs without paying as much attention to technique, enjoying every second and every beat. At this moment in my life, what matters the most to me and I'm trying to prioritize, it's my happiness. I try to learn everything I can to be a better person every day. I think life is about trying and making mistakes, while trying to find what makes you happy. We have a lot of time at our disposal and many things to do. If life has no other meaning than to be alive, it is our goal to do the best we can and live to improve and understand ourselves more and more. Along the way, we are learning, and if we help other people in the meantime, we will have won in this game with such unclear rules. The only thing I can think of these days that the world is going through is how privileged I am. I live with a nice family who helps me and supports me. I have food, health, and I have no major worries in life. It took me a while to realize, but not all people are that lucky. We are all different, with different experiences and different problems. There are many people living on the street hungry, people who are going through this situation on their own, suffering from racism, fighting against lack of work, or sick with this virus, or any other disease that threatens to kill them. My situation is very comfortable and privileged, and it shouldn't be that way. We should all have the possibility to sleep peacefully, have a plate of food, or enjoy good health. I believe that understanding these issues is essential for us to help each other. Actually, I don't make a lot of comments on the videos I watch. I felt that I had to make that comment because behind those hands, those brushes, that music and those videos, there had to be a story that the people who watch your videos don't know. I never thought I was going to get an answer, that you were going to paint me, or that you were going to let me ask you questions about life. I was surprised and grateful to have this contact with someone that I admire and, without knowing it, helps me improve my music and teaches me to enjoy it. I hope the finished painting looks good, and I want to thank you for this unexpected experience. And again, I hope you never stop uploading videos.